There are a number of people who aren't happy with a conventional knee replacement performed for arthritis, and that's led to a widening of our indications for patients to be considered for a partial knee replacement. That includes some patients whose body mass index exceeds 35 or even sometimes 40 kilograms per meter squared. In our practice in the Midwest, it's probably not much different than what a number of other doctors experience, is that we have probably 15 to 20% of our patients who come to us with a body mass index above 40. And so we performed a study to look at what our experience had been here with a single surgeon who had done a large volume of unicompartmental knee replacement performed with a mobile bearing device. We saw about a 15% rate of conversion, and then we saw a clinical failure rate was a little bit above 30%. So at about 3 to 4 year time frame, that's where we saw a lot of these failures having occurred. When we looked at patients who had a total knee replacement, again, that failure rate was similar to what we saw in patients who were non-morbidly obese with a partial knee replacement. The failure rate was around 2 to 3%. I'm much more guarded about using a partial knee replacement in general, but certainly for patients who are morbidly obese. And I think that the surgeons who should be doing it are surgeons who are higher volume surgeons doing the operation. I think at the end of the day, we have to make sure that we're counseling our patients very well and they understand that if they do undergo this surgery and they have a higher body mass index, that they do have a higher risk of having a failure. It's very important for our surgeons and each of us as we take on this operation that we're ensuring that we're doing our best and our patients have the best chance of a good outcome. Some of that's possibly patient selection. Some of it also is going to be making sure that we're technically doing this as best as we can.